Oh, yes, rub yourself on everything there. Meow, 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 meow. Show your butt to the camera, nerds. That was nice. Okay, so throughout my career as an eye doctor, I have fit many people in different types of contact lenses, from soft daily contact lenses to the hard gas permeable contact lenses, all the way up to the huge scleral contacts that we fit for people with diseased eyes like keratoconus and post-surgical cases. But one of the more common questions I get here on this channel and across Instagram and Twitter is about Ortho K contact lenses, also known as orthokeratology. And these are some of the coolest lenses you've ever heard of. So buckle yourselves up because we're gonna dive deep into orthokeratology and just some of the craziest contacts you've ever seen. Let's take a look. You wanna get down? Meow. Ooh, that one's cute, good jump. Hey, what's up? This is Dr. Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you see your very best. Now, what if I was to tell you that there's a way that you could see clearly without wearing glasses or contacts throughout the day? Note how I said throughout the day, and we'll get to that. But what if I said there was also a way that we could slow down the rate of progression of your child's nearsightedness? You know the way that your kid's glasses get worse and worse every single year? Yeah, there's a way that we can slow that down. And we can do that with a little piece of plastic here, an Ortho K contact lens. Ortho K is short for a term called orthokeratology, which chances are you've never heard of that term, so let me break it down for you. Ortho is derived from the Latin word meaning straight, and then keratology is the science of altering the shape of the cornea. That's the clear front window surface to the eye. So in short, Ortho K contact lenses is just a way of using a contact lens to mold or sculpt the front surface of the eye so that you can see better. Now, the whole concept of orthokeratology has actually been around for quite some time, with it being said that people used to put weights and sandbags onto their eyelids, and then they would notice that some people would see better afterwards. And I don't recommend that you try that, but if you've ever done a warm compress for the eyes, whether it be for dry eyes or an eyelid dye, you may have noticed that your vision is hazy or a little bit different for at least about 30 minutes afterward. And that's not just because oils are being released from the eyelids, that's true, but in fact, it's the cornea being morphed or warped by the pressure of that warm compress. It's essentially the same basic theory. In fact, the first time this was ever used in eye care was from a French ophthalmologist of the name Eugene Kurt, who noted that when he fit his patients with glass contact lenses and it pushed on the eye, they could see better afterward. Now, what I find so crazy and cool about these contacts is that they're basically kind of the backwards contact lens, where a lot of time on this channel, I have said that, hey, it's not good to wear your contact lenses to bed at nighttime, where these type of contacts are custom made and specifically designed to be worn while you sleep. That way you wear the contact lens at nighttime while you're sleeping, it shapes and molds the surface of your eye, and then the next morning you take out the contact lens, and then you see clearly throughout the day. So again, it's kind of backwards. Wow, you're really just gonna stand there like a gargoyle, aren't you? I love her anyway. Now, the reason all of this works is because the front part of the cornea, the very front of it, has cells called the epithelium. It's about 50 microns thick. And this contact lens will push on that central epithelium and basically squeeze the fluid from the center of the cornea out to farther edges. And that kind of makes a plateau shape. And that makes the light that's entering your eye focus more correctly onto the retina in the back of the eye, giving you better vision. The catch to all this is that the central cornea does reform and kind of spring back to its original shape, which requires you to wear these types of Ortho K lenses at nighttime every single night. In fact, it takes about 1 to 2 weeks of wearing them every night just to get the eye to be about the shape that it needs to be in order to see your very best. And then you also need to keep wearing the lenses every night. Otherwise, if you don't, the surface of the eye will kind of regress back to its original shape and you won't see as clearly again. It basically just goes back to what your vision was like before you started wearing these type of contacts. So who makes a good candidate for Ortho K lenses? Certainly not Zelda here, but anybody who doesn't really like to wear glasses or contact lenses throughout the day, maybe an athlete, for example. Maybe if you're not a good candidate for something like LASIK eye surgery, or maybe you have bad dry eyes and can't wear contacts throughout the day either, then perhaps you might be a good candidate for it. Now, there are different brands of Ortho K contact lenses, at least the ones that I am certified in, that I am familiar with. Those lenses are approved for people up to -6 diopters of power with up to -1.75 diopters of astigmatism correction. So unfortunately, if you do have a really unique prescription in your glasses or contacts, or you have a really high power, these still may not be an option for you, but it's still something to ask your doctor about. And you know who else makes a really excellent candidate for these types of lenses? Those are children. And that's because studies have shown that using these types of lenses, they can slow down the rate of their progression to nearsightedness by almost up to 50%. Now, the exact way that this happens is a really complex scientific discussion, so I'm gonna save that for another video. But because Ortho K lenses can have this extra benefit of slowing down how thick kids' glasses can get, that's why so many eye doctors are kind of jumping into this, because it is a way that we can slow down their glasses from getting worse and help prevent future disease and even blindness for people. And that whole study of trying to slow down or prevent myopia from getting worse is called either myopia control or myopia management. And I do plan to cover a lot more videos on that topic, so definitely keep an eye out for that. But let me know in the comments, have you heard of Ortho K lenses before? Is this a completely new thing for you? Or have you worn them yourself? Have you good success? Let us know in the comments about that. Chances are, if you haven't heard of Ortho K lenses, that's okay. Not every eye doctor does fitting for these type of lenses. In fact, I had to go through a special extra certification course just to be able to prescribe and fit these lenses. But it is something that is becoming more popular, and more eye doctors are getting into it and starting to offer it through their clinics. But again, if you are somebody who's looking for an alternative to wearing glasses and contacts throughout the day, maybe you're not a good candidate for LASIK or other forms of refractive surgery, maybe you're scared of doing surgery, or perhaps high amounts of nearsightedness or myopia runs in your family and you just want to know what other options there are to helping your kids out, then I definitely recommend to look into something like Orthokeratology. And you can always ask your eye doctor about if they offer that. Be sure to tell them Dr. Eye Health sent you. Hey, I hope you enjoyed today's video and you learned a lot and you didn't just stare at the cute cat the whole time. But if you did enjoy the video, hit that like button for me, because that is gonna help me out with this channel. It's gonna tell YouTube that this video is something that's good, that people will wanna watch, and that'll help my mission of helping educate more people around the world and helping them take better care of their eyes. So thanks for doing that for me. Subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already. Otherwise, keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.